And yeah, it said 3-game, but he didn't listen, man. I was there with my bone through my nose and everything.
Yeah. Well, that's right. A witch doctor, right? Shaman see that too?
I think it's somewhat nebulous. You know what I mean? They refer to like roles in different tribes. You know?
Sure.
But I could be wrong. Let us know on Twitter.
Yeah.
Call me Daces and Artosis.
That's right. Well, Holt playing a pretty standard follow-up to this failed proxy here. He's going just into the three racks, throwing up his double gas. And looks like he'll be playing just standard from here. He'll go up to his medevacs and whatnot. Parting in the meantime. Throwing up gates. You think he's going to 4-gate?
Well, he could. I think anything that's going to be aggression, like, you know, before the Terran gets the tech up, is going to be pretty strong here. When you think of the number of Marines that aren't in these bunkers, and the fact that this bunker just got canceled, I mean, I feel like a lot of damage could be dealt out here, but so far, it doesn't look like he's going to do that. He's getting a robotics bay.
Yeah, Harding is one of these players that has a plan going into the game and doesn't necessarily react to what he sees. He's one of the best players at executing things in the entire game.
You're 100% right. He goes in there with a very specific build.
Yeah.
Maps it out.
Yeah.
And he's going to do that build. He's not somebody who's going to see this and switch it up like that.
Yeah, this isn't the guy that comes up with the best builds in the world. This is the guy that executes them better than anyone else. And we've seen that with his Mortal Sentry push. We've seen that with his three Nexus plays. Really, Squirtle is the one that's coming up with most of this guy's builds. But
I agree.
He'll take them, and his micro is better, and his macro is on par with basically any Protoss. So,
right.
He knows how to make stuff work. So even though he's scouting, he knows that, like, okay, if I see this, I do that. If I see that, I do this, et cetera, et cetera. But
right.
He's not going to freestyle his way through this.
Very well said, Artosis. Now we got the Observer coming in here. This is going to be the first glimpse for the Protoss into what the Terran's up to. And I do get why maybe Parney didn't get too aggressive. I think he wants to err on the side of caution. That last game was really weird.
Yeah.
I mean, super really weird.
And even getting that one Colossus out right away is going to make him safe against basically anything.
Yep.
Opening one single Colossus means you're not going to lose in the early game. Unless you really bungle it. So he's getting that. He's getting the one forge. That gives him a lot of room to maneuver. And, in fact, he's adding a couple more gates. Going up to 5 gates already. That is really quick 5-gate.
Do you think he's going to stay on 2-base? I mean, 5 gates with a robo? Or with a robo support bay? I mean...
You know what?
I mean...
He's getting the armor. I mean, no, I think he's just going to chill on these. Those are 4 producing a lot of units. And
he's,
making sure he's safe.
He's also in a Citadel.
Yeah. Not surprised.
Twilight Council, I should say.
It's a Citadel.
It's a Citadel, man.
Does it make Zealot legs?
It's a Citadel. You're right.
It's a Citadel, Tasteless.
All right.
Look, I'm not a Shakuris, a Dune equalist, okay? I know that once they teamed up forces, they changed it to Twilight Council, but it's a Citadel of a Dune, okay?
All right, you win. Now,
I don't care, Zeratul.
Dude, Terran should actually scan his army right now. There's always an observer over your army in this phase of the game. Looks like Stim's done. Combat Shield is not. Now they're leaving that location. I think the observer is tracing him. Or it was.
No,
Observer was over the army a minute ago, but it looks like it went back.
Yeah, no, he lost it. He made another one.
Did he scan it then?
Yeah.
So he did exactly what I said he needed to do?
Yeah.
Well, he needs to do that. He probably killed it. More gateways coming down here now.
Yeah, he's going right into charge plus Templar with a single Colossus for safety. And he will go for a third base relatively soon here. He just wants to make sure that he has enough, that there's no way for him to really die. So he's already trying to get that set up, but Holt gonna try to stall that out a little bit because he already does have his third base, so as long as he can keep parting off of that, the less effective Parting's tech is gonna be.
Sure.
A lot of income for a lot of charge logs.
Right, that pylon's been taken out now. And let's see here. He's going Storm. He is gonna finish almost all the upgrades on 2 bases, which is pretty rare in this matchup, but I guess you can do that.
And, you know, he's I think he's just trying to make sure he doesn't lose right away, because as we saw, if Parting makes it to the late game, he literally just doesn't lose. He's actually, as far as PBT go, remember, he was basically the PBT Bonjour. He was just killing every single Terran with perfect size storms, perfect map control, that type of thing. So he just wants to get there to where he's comfortable.
And, you know, when you look at it, guys, we're already at almost 13 minutes, so we're only halfway there to getting past that part. Parting's never lost. So if, let's say, Polt is to win after that 30-minute marker, we're going to make history. Well, Polt's going to make history, and we're going to cast it.
That's right.
Polt, like, does it. I'm like, we did it. I know we can do it on our toes as we're hugging each other.
We go out and high-five Polt. He's like, oh, thanks.
We're going to go get drunk now, Artosis. We did it, man.
Yay.
Polt beat Parting after 30 minutes.
All right. Third Nexus is going up. He has Psystorm and Charge done.
He doesn't have three CDs on gas at his third, at least last time we had a glimpse of it. He might get that fixed soon. Oh, and he does just now. Perfect.
Yep.
Scanning. Now, he could go in there and snipe that. I mean, the factory is a bit of a distraction over here.
Yeah. Well, Polt, I don't think there's much for him to do here. Parting's kind of on the ball.
Ooh.
And yeah, he has to run away from stuff like
this. Oh, but he could actually loop around.
Yeah, he might
and
be
he
able
could
to
even pick up and leave after this. Did he just trick Parting? I think he did.
That's huge.
That
wow.
is so smart.
Well,
the stim, as they came out, was someone was so smart about it, because initially I looked at that and I said, God, that's a lot of wasted HP.
Yeah, that was really good. I'm surprised Parting walked out. There was actually no reason for it.
Well, I'm just surprised that he let Polt outmaneuver him. Granted, that was high-level stuff from Polt. Parting was playing so well.
He was luring him
and
like he was
And there's actually not enough anti-air here. Parting in a lot of trouble. Now, stimming up here. Polt is going up here, hitting the Stalkers with the Zealots now, driving him back. Nice kiting, though.
And I got to say, this just isn't good play from Parting right now.
Parting Polt's looks distracted and a little bit sloppy. Storm coming down here. Dodge. Not even a single Terran unit killed by that storm.
Well, in the meantime, he did hold off a little counterattack to third base, but Parting is just not playing his best right now. This is really weird. Like, he walked down that ramp. I can't believe he walked down, because obviously his third can be attacked. He's playing like he's against someone that's on the ladder and is afraid of
him. I was thinking the exact same thing. Like, he's against somebody who's on the ladder, and it's not.
And they're like, oh, my God, I'm playing Parting. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God, I'm just going to stim and run in here. Cross my fingers.
Yeah, well, anyways.
Polt may lose this battle here.
Yeah, it's going okay right now for Parting.
Oh, there's reinforcements coming in here.
Yes,
from the left.
Stuck behind you.
The Archons are not finished yet, too.
Yeah, and he's actually taking a ton of damage here. In fact, good thing for him, he has some Zealots coming from the side, but that may not even be enough. And Parting.
Wow, look at this.
Uh-oh. Well, Tasteless. This is bad. Polt is up by over 50 supply right now. Parting has just about nothing left at this point.
Yeah, in fact, Parting, he can tap out here. I mean,
yeah,
he is so limited. But look at the supplies here, 80 to 142. Polt is regrouping.
Thing is, he's warping a lot of Zealots. What he needs to do is focus on warping in High Templars and be so cost efficient with them.
I think what Polt needs to do is pick up and drop the main.
You're probably pretty right about that, Jesus. I mean, there are some cannons up there, but those cannons are wimps.
I don't think it's going to be enough, though. I think he drops those cannons, and it's like easy peasy.
Well, there's just not. Oh, God. And in fact, Parting right now is just adding a lot of Archons. So
he's going to land the factory, too, over here at the during this attack.
That's brutal. And he lets his charge get used up on the factory. That is bad. Parting in a lot of trouble here. He has some Archons, but he doesn't have any size storm, and he's having a hard time even closing with this army.
Oh, man. He might actually get the third now.
Yeah, this is.
There's two more bases being taken here from Polt. This, oh my God, I cannot believe how well Polt's playing. That's basically it. I think we should see a GG here, unless Parting just tries to stay in. He tries to come to his senses and be like, my God, I lost this game.
Yeah,
GG.
Well,
damn.
Polt is playing really well today, really, really well. Parting. On the other hand, with the first game I'm fine with, because that's just like happens sometimes. But
well, that was like a good build order win.
Yeah, it was kind of a good build order win.
Game two, I mean, Polt looked like he was the better player.
Yeah, Parting walking down that ramp actually lost him the game. If he just zones out, he has his expand up and everything looks different the entire time. But when that Nexus got a force cancel and it was almost done, when that happens and Terrence had his third forever, you just die. Like, you're not going to stop that. Holt's never going to stop attacking you. So,
well, you know, Parting's not done yet because he's going to go up against, well, hopefully a Zerg for his sake. I don't know. And then again, I don't know if Sniper's going to lose. I don't know. Parting just didn't play like what we're used to seeing.
No, he didn't.
You can't just PBZ your way to a GSL Finals. And you think maybe you
this
could
would
in this
be the season to do it,
right?
Too, right?
Because there's so many Zergs here, but not the case. So, after this, we're going to go on to our TBZ. It's going to be Innovation against Sniper. So don't go away. We'll be back here soon at the GSL Code S.